So first things first, I think I'm gonna get on and install this fuel tank. It's always in the way at the moment. I've got some new pads that have been glued onto it. They're now dry, stop it from rubbing on all the edges. And I've just got to change out that fuel hose at the bottom for a new item. So this is becoming a little bit of an annoyance now. I've probably spent the last 2 to 3 hours trying to get this tank in. It's in the correct position. It's as back as it can be. It's nice and level. However, both tank straps are now falling short of their mounting for me to secure them. The only reason that could be is because I've put these new protective pads in just to stop the tank from rubbing on the top and the bottom. However, the tank did have them on there before, albeit a little bit worn. I've ground both bolts out that I've welded in. I was initially going to put a longer bolt in and just try and get it like that. I'm now thinking I'm going to extend the straps. I shouldn't see why I have to do that though, to be honest with you. It should just meet, but it's not. I'm now toying with the idea of cutting it just above that sort of L bracket, welding a piece in that I need to obviously get it down to that clip, and then re-welding this bracket on, and then that should get it. Obviously welding in a new bolt as well for me to get a nut on the underside there, but highly annoying. It shouldn't have happened like that. I'm more annoyed that I've got to cut and weld in a space that I've already painted. Hopefully I won't regret doing that, but it is the only way that I can think of coming out of the woods, apart from not having a fuel tank with any pads on it. So I'm going to cut a strip, it's probably only an extra inch or so, and re-weld it into that tab, and then re-weld it onto the actual strap itself, and tidy it up. Hopefully I'll be able to make it look as good as it was. If you ever wondered, the tank strap's 20mm width. I'm not going to need that whole length, so now to measure it and cut it down. And there it is, that's the small tank strap extension. So I've put a little step in the top there just so I can overlap the existing strap and then plug weld it in place. So I've just got to find a couple of bolts now, because I'm going to have to weld those into there, and then we'll try and get it back on the existing strap. So they're pretty much both ready to weld in now. What I've done is I've just notched the head of that bolt just so I can get a bit of weld in there. Right, so it's time to weld the tank extensions in that I've made, and hopefully a combination of a fire blanket and my welder's apron will protect the paint around. Thank you. I've got to admit that I'm the worst plug welder in the world. But I'll just give them a coat of Lotus White. Job done. Just hope the tank fits. Okay, so what I've been doing during the week after work is just spending a couple of hours here and there and getting the engine tinware prepped and put in primer. Now, I've already done that, so the next move is going to be laying down a base coat, which is going to be the satin black. And it occurred to me that there was a few questions when I was doing the engine bay on what the actual gun was that I was using. So this is it. It's an electric spray gun made by TacLife. And to be honest, it was just purchased so I could move along in the project without having a very expensive outlay of buying a proper painting system. So it was just small parts that I needed to do inside the engine bay, the fuel tank cover, and other components, just silly little stuff. So it got me out of that hole really and moving along. With the gun itself, you've got to be a little bit careful. Really, you should start off doing your lower sections first, only because the pickup tube within the canister points to the front. So obviously, once your paint starts depleting in the canister and you're tipping it back, you're not going to pick it up on that tube. You can't be tipping the gun up at this angle anyway, because you're going to get a feed of paint moving to the rear where the motor is. You've also got to be careful that all the components of the gun are actually airtight, basically. Otherwise, you end up like me, and there was a few occasions where it looked like a scene out of Bugsy Malone with the old splurge guns. Just like if you've got a little air leak, out comes the paint from all the orifices. So just a few things to be careful. You've got a vertical and horizontal spray feed. You can adjust the volume of, well, it's just the volume of the trigger, basically, just how much paint you're going to be pumping for it. And that's about it. A get out of trouble gun for, what, 40 quid? Not bad. So I've just done a little scout about, really, for two things. One being what else needs painting in satin black before I get all the engine tinware done. And second, anything else that needs to go on the welding list. And then I discovered that. So I took the side rubbers off on both corners, and they're pretty much alike. The other one being, it's even got a load of wood stuffed in the corner just to bulk it out. So I've looked into them, and each corner is about the £100, £140 mark. So yeah, they're definitely going on the welding list. I mean, who even does that? That's it, got both hangers off now, and on to grinding all these bolts off because they're so rusted. A little bit of a moan, I hate the inconsistencies of just having one washer on all of those. You're going to do it, put them on all of them. Right, so I'm just going to continue working on these for a little bit more, and then I'm going to call it a day. So until the next one, see you then.